Electric motors. What are the benefits, the disadvantages? Just how much power can electric motors produce? And how do they stack up against combustion engines? That's what we are going to explore on this episode of What's What. Before we get started, subscribe below, give us a like, and share What's What with your fellow scientists. Can someone please turn that off? We are in a closed space here. Phew! Gas generators can cause a ruckus. Imagine if we went electric. Now, we apologize in advance to all your gearheads out there, but electric motors are a bit more simple than combustion engines. Electric motors have very few mechanical components in motion. That means no cylinders, injectors, turbo compressors. This also means less lubrication. And less lubrication means less maintenance. Less maintenance means less frowns. Electric motors are known to have 3 times fewer breakdowns than the standard combustion motor. Not only are electric motors more reliable, they are also easier on the ears. And they are a bit easier on the lungs too. Seriously, guys? Electric motors are silent because they vibrate less, as electric motors create torque via an electric field. Trippy. Electric cars have many benefits because of this. They can start immediately with no idling and are generally much lighter than gas power cars. They also offer a smoother ride because they only have one gear. And electric motors are compact, so they can be placed in the front or rear of the car. And perhaps the most important benefit, electric engines produce no particle pollution and have low CO2 emission if they are charged with decarbonized electricity. But when it comes to electric engines, it is not all sunshines and rainbows. They do have some flaws. First up, we got batteries. The ones used to power electric engines are a little bit bigger than this. In most cases, batteries can be the heaviest part of an electric system. On top of that, each battery has a lifespan and needs to be charged accordingly. Some other factors, like material depletion and recycling, come into the conversation as well. Then, the availability of loading stations. If you purchase or own an electric car, you might know that it can be hard to find a place to charge your vehicle. Even worse, when the engine breaks down in electric cars, the wheels lock, making it harder to get a tow. And despite subsidies, electric cars come at a higher cost. But thanks to all those brilliant scientists within the electric motor industry, new technologies are discovered every day. Now, let's take a look at the different kinds of electric motors. Yes, this is my favorite part too.
Hey, that's my cue.
No.
Oh yeah. It's Vanessa here again to talk to you about some engines. Motor science can be complicated. To keep things simple, we're going to briefly explain the 2 main types of electric motors. First up, we have the DC, or direct current motor. These motors are common in industrial machines, anytime that adjustable speed and load torque is required. These puppies take electric energy and convert it into mechanical energy. Basically, they're electric machines that take electricity through a direct current and create mechanical rotation with the power supply. If mechanical energy is foreign to any of you electricians out there, just remember that it's any energy that's created by working objects. Direct current is an electric current that is unidirectional, and unlike an alternating current, its amperage doesn't change. It can be channeled by conductors, semiconductors, or a vacuum. That's why it's used for electric engines, like the DC.
So we got the DC motor down. But what about the AC motors?
This one is driven by an alternating current, and it consists of 2 basic parts, an exterior stator and an interior rotor. both of which produce their own magnetic fields to create energy. The AC motor can be manufactured in two forms: synchronous, where the rotor speed and the stator speed are equal, or asynchronous, where the rotor speed is a lower rate than the stator. AC motors are efficient, quiet, and durable, generally used for pumps, heaters, and off-road vehicles. Well, that finishes up our crash course on electric motors. Now, how about some history? Did you know the first asymmetrical tricycle was invented by Gustave Trouvé in 1881? And guess who created the first electric outboard motor in 1884? That's right, Gustave again. What a guy. And the first electric car to reach 100 kilometers an hour. Hey, Frédéric, was that Gustave too?
No, it was La Jamais Contente, created by Camille Genazzi. If you want to learn more, check out our Ask Me What episode on electric cars.
Well, there you go. And how about the first electric motorcycle to reach not 100, but 400 kilometers per hour? Frédéric, do you know who that was? Well, I got you on that one. His name is Max Biaggi, and his motorcycle, that's called the Vauxhall Wattman. And Biaggi is still breaking motorcycle speed records today. So I guess electric motors, they do pack a punch. But there are many other benefits of electric motors as well. So electric motors have the advantage of going micro, and they're generally lighter than combustion engines, as Frederic mentioned earlier. That's why electric motors are used to power bikes and scooters. And now, skateboards,
segways, unicycles, cars, trucks, trains, trams, buses, cruise lines, and even submarines. Did I mention hoverboards?
Okay, slow down. To review our episode, remember electric engines have some benefits and drawbacks, and there are two specific types, the DC and AC engine. And in spite of popular myth, electric engines have actually been around for quite some time. That's all the time we have for today's episode. Thanks for tuning in. Like the world of science, the technology of electric motors is ever evolving and apparent now more than ever. Have a look. Do you see any electric motors around you?